Hi, Kerry here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. Today we're going to have a look at the budgeting feature that's available in the QuickBooks Online Plus Plan. I'm not going to go into a lot of detail here because I have a quite detailed budgeting video that there's a link for whichever side it's on. So we'll look through an overview so you can see basically how to create the budget in QuickBooks Online and determine whether or not this is a feature that's useful to you. To have a look at what other features are available, there's the link below. Now we'll go to the sample company. Let's make a budget. Okay, from the sample company, we'll pop up here, look under tools, and find budgeting. There's the option to add your first budget. So let's choose add budget. Now notice that you can prepare this budget by month, by quarter, or by year. And then you can pre-fill it with actual information from last year, actual information so far this year, which could be useful. And we have to name it, so let's name our budget 2020 budget. You can see here it's pre-filled information up to September, but there's nothing here for October, November, and December. If we changed it to 2019, I don't know why it's not filling in, maybe because it's the sample company, but if you had your real company and you had information there, it would fill in with that. Or you could just say no. You have the additional option to set up a budget either by a customer, a class, or a location. Customer is pretty self-explanatory. You may want to have a different budget just for perhaps, as maybe even here, Freeman Sporting Goods. Look at this, we do a lot of different work for them. It might make sense to create a different budget for them. I haven't really come across that. More typically would be by class or location, and if you don't know what that means, I have different videos explaining those. So once you've decided whether you want it to be by month, quarter, or year, whether or not you're going to pre-fill and how you'd like to subdivide this, you can click Next. And you can see here the option to enter in the numbers. So perhaps we're going to say for our landscaping services in January, we expect it to be 1500. And you know what? We expect 1500 all the way across. So then we just copy it across the row. And we go through line by line by line, entering the different amounts that we would like to have for our budget. So we'll pop something here in for expenses as well. Let's just put job expenses here, 500, just so we have something to look at when we do our report, and we'll copy that across. You can see how this is kind of a tedious process. So now let's save our budget and have a look here where we have the option to run a budget's overview report. So here you can see our budget for 2020 involves income of $1,500 a month and job expenses of $500 a month. Not that exciting, obviously you would fill that out a little more. Now if we do go back to the report list, there's an additional report that's set up in QuickBooks for the budget, and it's budget versus actual. So here it runs a report that compares your actual to budget each month, and because this isn't real, it's not very interesting, but you can see here that for each month you would be able to compare your actual expenses and income to the budgeted income expenses, and any variance would appear here. And that's your basic default budgeting in QuickBooks Online. Personally, I find the budgeting feature in QuickBooks Online a little cumbersome. I do use it, but I don't really like it. If you set your budget and just want to report against it and don't really change it much, it's not a bad feature, it works. But if you have a more agile business where you're wanting to do forecasting or perhaps look at some different options, this might not be the best feature for you. There are some fantastic applications out there. Do reach out if you want help to choose any, because I really enjoy finding the right tools for people. There's so much available now. Other than that, good luck with your budgeting. Click on the blog below that'll show all the different features that are available in the different QuickBooks plans. Click like, subscribe to my channel, and hopefully I'll see you again soon. Cheers.